The Blind Assassin by Margaret Atwood is a novel that is as amazing as it is confusing, with a peculiar writing style and many twists and turns that had me at the edge of my seats many times. It is about the life of Iris Chase Griffin, the ups, downs, and truths about it. It also contains a story within a story that adds another layer of feeling to the novel. The story within the story in The Blind Assassin directly reflects off of the plot of the actual story. There are many brutal things that occur on the planet of Zykron, where the story within the story takes place, especially for the sake of fortune and social standing among the Snilfards, rich people. If a Snilfard should become bankrupt, he might be demoted to a Nirod, or he might avoid such a fate by selling his wife or children in order to redeem his debt. This quote perfectly describes the system of exchange of humans for wealth and continuous status. This type of exchange can also be seen in the book, where Iris's father makes her marry Richard Griffin due to his promise that he would save their button factory if she did. Iris's father exchanges her to keep their wealth and status. To try to escape from being seen as new money, Richard thinks that marrying Iris, a woman with the family history of wealth and status, will earn him more respect in society. In the story within a story, to go from being a Nirod to a Snilford could be obtained by marrying into the rich or selling your family members, but you still were not respected because you came from Nirod roots and not Snilford roots. The Blind Assassin and the Sacrificial Girl represent Alex and Iris, and also how they fit together. The Blind Assassin represents Alex because Alex is poor and has nothing to lose, much like the slave children. He becomes free like the slave children do when they become a blind assassin. He becomes free by going to war, which is a cousin of assassination. This frees him because he is no longer forced to live his life hiding and sneaking around forever. Thus, tongueless and swollen with words she could never again pronounce, each girl would be led to the procession to the sound of solemn music, wrapped in veils and garlanded with flowers, up the winding steps to the city's ninth door. Nowadays, you might say she looked like a pampered society bride. Iris is a sacrificial girl at this point of the story, due to the fact that the sacrificial girls had their tongues cut off of them to keep them from screaming, and Iris has no real voice about her marriage with Richard. The sacrificial girls are also always from Snilfard families, and Iris is also from an elite family. As stated in the quote, they looked like a pampered society bride, which is comparable to Iris. The blind assassin and the sacrificial girl fall in love with Touch, since one of them is blind and one is silent. Alex and Iris also fall in love with Touch, knowing that they have someone to rely on, and they also have a child together. The blind assassin throughout the entire novel is actually Death. Death is blind. It catches anyone, no matter their status, age, wealth, or gender. It is comparable to the blind assassin who kills whoever they are told to kill because they serve a greater purpose. Death takes Laura, who suffers throughout the entire novel, being in the shadow of love between Alex and Iris and being raped by Richard. Death also takes Richard, who deserves it because he's a disgusting rapist, but it just proves that wealth and status mean nothing in Death's eyes. Their sense of hearing was acute. They could walk without sound and squeeze through the smallest of openings. They could smell the difference between a deep sleeper and one who was restlessly dreaming. They killed as softly as a moth brushing against your neck. They were considered to be without pity. They were much feared. In this quote, a blind assassin is described as something of great power and immortality, someone who transcends human skills, who would be Death. The blind assassin is described to be very quiet, creeping up on its victims without them knowing unless he wants them to. In many parts of the novel, Death was sneaky and at times unexpected, like the death of Iris's daughter, Amy, who died from an accidental slip and fall. The story within the story in this novel has apparent similarities with the actual story. Some of the correlations are the marriage between Iris and Richard and the Snilfards trading children for wealth and status, the similarities between Alex and Iris and the blind assassin and the sacrificial girl, and finally the fact that Death is the ultimate blind assassin. Death may be the blind assassin in this novel, but is it also the blind assassin in our real world?